an episode back, you were saying that he was a legend.
Let me give you an example of how these things can develop from a, you know, if you're going back to antiquity, right? You ought to read some books dating back to that period. Some of the histories of the Roman Empire, for example. A really entertaining book is called The 12 Caesars by a writer named Suetonius, who essentially wrote this collection of biographies of the first 12 Roman emperors from Augustus onward. Not only is it a terrific, very entertaining book to read, but what you will find in his histories is that because of the mentality and the beliefs that were common among even intellectuals of his day, he will report on things like omens, okay, and divine visitations or signs, what have you. And these will be taken seriously, and these were taken seriously by people of their day. For example, Roman generals and the emperors, people leading the troops into battle. Stories would circulate among, you know, the legionnaires and the centurions about how, you know, a hawk came down from the sky and circled the general's head three times and, you know, took a poop on his helmet, and this signifies whatever. Or they would read the entrails of a goat. This kind of stuff was taken seriously back then. Curses were taken seriously. Divinations were taken seriously. And he incorporates a lot of this supernatural content into what is, for the most part, a very straightforward history of the first 12 Roman emperors. Now, it doesn't mean that these days we pretty much are fairly confident these kinds of supernatural occurrences don't really exist. But when you have a culture that is seeped in those kinds of beliefs, this kind of boundary between fantasy, reality, what have you, blurs. And so it is no wonder that a similar story or set of stories might emerge from a figure like Jesus, an itinerant Jewish rabbi who developed a following, became something of a rabble-rouser, a thorn in Rome's side, as it were. And from that point on, the legend kind of develops. So it's not to say that the character, the person himself, Jesus Christ or Yeshua or whatever his original name is, was not a historical person in any way, shape, or form. But what it means is, like a lot of the stories that were circulating about Roman generals and emperors and other famous people of the day, the reality of his life got mingled in with myth and legendary, and people would just build the stories and build upon them, and that's essentially what happens.